lift up thy people's head. Alleluia, alleluia, Jesus, true and living bread. Prince of life, for us thou livest, by thy body souls are healed. Prince of peace, thy peace thou givest, by thy blood is pardon sealed. Alleluia, alleluia, Word of God in flesh revealed. Life imparting heavenly manna, stricken rock with streaming side, heaven and earth with loud hosanna worship thee, the Lamb who died. Alleluia, alleluia, risen, ascended, glorified.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The Lord be with you. Hello and happy Sunday to everyone. Thank you for joining in with our celebration of Mass for this, the 18th Sunday in ordinary time. All the best to any of you who are having a holiday at this time, whether it's a staycation or a vacation. Thank you for letting the Lord Jesus join you, either at home or away. Last week we heard the story of the multiplication of the loaves and the feeding of the 5,000. We continue St. John's Gospel, chapter 6, today, as we think about the meaning of that miracle. In the Gospel acclamation, we say, we do not live on bread alone. And this is where Jesus is taking things in his teaching. He tells the crowd that it's not just about food for the body, the bread that they have received. There's something else going on with him and his gift. Just like the people of Israel, given manna, bread from heaven, on their journey in the wilderness, so too Jesus is a bread from heaven to nourish his people on their journey today. Let's pray that we may open our minds and hearts to hear the Lord's teaching, and that he may strengthen us on our journeys. As we prepare to celebrate these mysteries today, let us first call to mind our sins and ask for God's forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, so that, for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. The whole community of the sons of Israel began to complain against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness and said to them, "Why did we not die at the Lord's hand in the land of Egypt when we were able to sit down to pans of meat and could eat bread to our heart's content? As it is, you have brought us to this wilderness to starve this whole company to death." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Now I will rain down bread for you from the heavens. Each day the people are to go out and gather the day's portion. I propose to test them in this way to see whether they will follow my law or not. I have heard the complaints of the sons of Israel. Say this to them, 'Between the two evenings you shall eat meat, and in the morning you shall have bread to your heart's content. Then you will learn that I, the Lord, am your God.'" And so it came about. Quails flew up in the evening, and they covered the camp. In the morning, there was a coating of dew all around the camp. When the coating of dew lifted, there on the surface of the desert was a thing delicate, powdery, as fine as hoarfrost on the ground. When they saw this, the sons of Israel said to one another, "What is that?" not knowing what it was. "That," said Moses to them, "is the bread the Lord gives you to eat." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord gave them bread from
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. I want to urge you, in the name of the Lord, not to go on living the aimless kind of life that pagans live. Now, that is hardly the way you have learnt from Christ, unless you failed to hear him properly when you were taught what the truth is in Jesus. You must give up your old way of life. You must put aside your old self, which gets corrupted by following illusory desires. Your mind must be renewed by a spiritual revolution so that you can put on the new self that has been created in God's way, in the goodness and holiness of the truth. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. When the people saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they got into boats and crossed to Capernaum to look for Jesus. When they found him on the other side, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered, "I tell you most solemnly, you are not looking for me because you have seen the signs, but because you had all the bread you wanted to eat. Do not work for food that cannot last, but work for food that endures to eternal life, the kind of food the Son of Man is offering you, for on him the Father, God himself, has set his seal." Then they said to him, "What must we do if we are to do the works that God wants?" Jesus gave them this answer, "This is working for God. You must believe in the one he has sent." So they said, "What sign will you give us to show us that we should believe in you? What work will you do? Our fathers had manna to eat in the desert. As scripture says, he gave them bread from heaven to eat." Jesus answered, "I tell you most solemnly, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven. It is my Father who gives you the bread from heaven, the true bread. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." "Sir," they said, "give us that bread always." Jesus answered, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never thirst." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I don't know if you are avidly following the Olympic Games in Tokyo at the moment, but there was one news story that struck me this week. It was the news about Simone Biles, the American gymnast, the amazing and talented American gymnast, who has pulled out of different parts of the competition. And the reason why is because of her own mental health, her own, as it were, awareness of perhaps the harm that competition is doing her. I'm glad to see that people have actually raised this issue, because obviously mental health is important for all of us. We've all got to be aware of the pressures that are sometimes put on individuals in the public sphere, whether it's sport or anything else, and how that can have a negative impact. But there was one thing in that story last week that really jumped out at me. It was a tweet that Simone herself put on her Twitter feed, in which she said this: "The outpouring love and support I've received has made me realize I'm more than my accomplishments and gymnastics, which I never truly believed before. I'm more than gymnastics. I'm more than my accomplishments." Now, the reason that jumped out at me is I think that's where Jesus is leading the people in the gospel today, in his teaching. They come to him because they have witnessed and taken part in the miracle of the multiplication of the loaves, the feeding of the 5,000. As Jesus himself says, they have had all the bread they want to eat. But in a sense, Jesus almost tells them off for that. You're only coming because you've had enough bread to eat. You've got to be looking for more. There's more to life than mere food. They talk about the example of the people of Israel in the wilderness, who received that gift of manna after they were moaning about not having any food in the desert. But there too, there was a sense in which God, through Moses, was asking the people of Israel to realize there's more to life than food, whether it is the gift of quails and this strange substance called manna. God says, "I'm going to put them to the test to see if they will trust in me, to see if they will believe in me. There's more to life than food." And that's why Simone Biles' little tweet there, I think, spoke to me, because she's saying that she's come to a realization that there's more to life than gymnastics and winning medals. Olympic gymnasts, and in fact any elite athletes, are people who are so driven, who are so focused, who are so completely dedicated to their training, to that pursuit of excellence. And for her to actually say, no, actually, I've just realized there's more to life than just the achievements. There's more to life than gymnastics. I think that is a wonderful thing, because that's what Jesus wants all of us to realize. In a sense, it's that move from body to spirit, that move from what feeds and nourishes us physically, whatever that is, whether it is food and drink, or whether it is the occupations or the preoccupations of this earthly life, moving from that to something greater, something more. Whether you call it mind or spirit or soul, it leads to God. In God, we find more. We do not live on bread alone, but we live by faith and trust in God. This is the new person, the new us, that St. Paul was talking about in that second reading, leaving behind the old us and realizing there is more to life. So, what do we do with this? Well, we've all got to realize this same call. There's more to life than the merely physical, than the merely worldly. Perhaps we can use this summer time, if we get a little chance, to have a little think about those words. There's more to life than. What would we fill in that gap? There's more to life than work. There's more to life than money. There's more to life than worrying about X, Y, and Z. There's more to life than perhaps television or soap operas or Love Island or whatever it might be. There's more to life than. And then we let the Lord Jesus be the one that leads us on that path of discovery, that opens up that more, that opens up mind and heart and spirit and soul to that presence of God. God who feeds us and who nourishes us through the gift of His Son. There's more to life than food. There's more to life than the things of this world. Let's pray that we may open ourselves to the gift of the true bread. Not bread for the stomach, not bread for the body, but bread for the complete us, body and mind and spirit and soul. The bread which is Jesus given to us. Now, in union with the whole church throughout the world, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who, with the Father and the Son, is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray now that we may work for the food that endures to eternal life. Let's pray first for the world, that all peoples may work to create new bonds of love and respect for each other. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray for anyone preoccupied with the perishable things of this passing life. May the word of God inspire peoples to invest themselves in lasting work for the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray for the lost and for all who hunger for spiritual life. May the bread of God's word and the life of the Spirit lead them to deeper intimacy with Jesus, the bread of life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And let us pray for our deceased brothers and sisters who appear before Christ hungry for life eternal. May the one who is sealed by the resurrection welcome our deceased into heaven's banquet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And for a moment in silence, let us think of our own prayers or our prayers for those who have asked us to pray for them. And we ask our Mother Mary to join us in all these prayers as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through our Lord Jesus Christ. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Vincent, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I am the bread of life. not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father draw him, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world, and if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just once again wish you all the best for the Lord's Day, for a happy Sunday. I hope that it is a day of rest and a day of peace. Also, again, all the best to you if you're finding the chance to get a holiday at this time of year. But remember where Jesus leads us in the gospel. There's more to life than just those physical things, than just food and drink, than perhaps just work or whatever preoccupations we have. Let's use this time to think, what is the more that Jesus, the bread of life, is calling us to embrace? The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.
Lesson taught.